Good evening and welcome to News Channel 8. I'm Jerome Agian, and here's some of the top stories we have for you tonight. A Virgin Islands senator says the government layoffs are unfair. Who dropped the ball as a suspect jumps bail? And it's furball time for the pets at the animal shelter. These stories and more are up next on News Channel 8. Top story tonight, at least one Virgin Islands senator says enough is enough. Senator Janet Millen-Young is speaking out against the governor's plans to lay off government workers. News Channel 8's Wes Small talked with the freshman senator earlier today on the phone.
All right, on the line with us right now, Senator from St. Thomas, Janet Millen-Young. And thank you very much, Senator, for spending time with us this evening. You've just issued a press release about proposed layoffs unfair to lower salaried workers. And you've also got a little bit more to add. Please explain to us what's going on. Thank you.
And thank you for the opportunity to share with you my sentiments regarding the governor's announced intention to lay off 300 part-time and per diem employees of the government. I am adamantly against any such action that would severely impact the lives of those who have been identified for layoffs and their families. It is my opinion that it is not a wise move to take so many employees off of the payroll, because not only are there very limited opportunities for them to seek employment elsewhere, but we're also in a different situation from our friends on the mainland. If you become unemployed on the U.S. mainland or even Puerto Rico, you have the option of perhaps moving to another city or remaining in your home city, but to be able to commute to another city for work. There's also the social impact to layoffs in such numbers. When you take away the paycheck of someone who's not even making any large amount of money, then you must be prepared to support them and perhaps their families through public support services such as unemployment, food stamps, and other assistance. My understanding is that those who are slated to be laid off make an average of $8,000 per annum for savings of $2.4 million. Surely, we as a government can find that money. I am committed to sit at the table with my colleagues at the legislature to huddle and identify measures that will serve to bring in new revenues to the territory while at the same time identifying cost-saving measures for our government operations. This second part is as important as, or even more important than bringing in new revenues. We all have a responsibility of spending less and working in a more efficient manner when we're dealing with public funds. But make no mistake, I'm not going to be party to having to search for ways to bring in more money into our territory's coffers and not be mindful of ensuring that it is properly spent. And so that is where we as legislators come in, to ensure that one of our major duties is covered, and that is the duty to provide proper oversight of government spending.
And we want to thank Senator Janet Millen-Young for her words tonight. And it looks like, in other news tonight, the judicial system has dropped the ball again. We're talking about embezzlement suspect Justin Lickout. And believe it or not, he's on the loose again. Here's Melody Rames as she reveals that someone forgot the bracelet. And also, it's time to reveal the new song entitled You Can Run, But You Can't Hide by the Fusion Band, which is the theme song to the new police-saturated patrols. Here's Melody Rain.
Don't run, don't hide. The run that you do will burn the judge alive. Said, don't run, don't hide. The run that you do will burn the judge alive. Said, don't run.
Police have issued a wanted poster for Justin Lickout, who failed to appear at his advisor rights hearing on Tuesday, February 1st. Lickout was previously arrested on January 21st and charged with obtaining money by false pretense, grand larceny, and drawing and delivering more than $11,000 in worthless checks to several businesses on St. Croix. He was remanded to jail at that time. And on Friday, Insular Investigation Bureau detectives arrested Lickout again while still in jail, charging him with trespassing and operating a business without a license. His bail in that case was set at $1,000 and he was returned to custody. Lickout was bailed out shortly after his return to jail and has not been seen since. Police said Lickout, age 35, has been wearing an electronic monitor on his ankle since his arrest on assault charges in 2010. However, once he is incarcerated, the monitor is removed. Police said the monitor should have been reattached to Lickout when he was bailed out of jail, but it was not. So if you have seen Justin Lickout lately or know where he may be staying or who he is in contact with, please call the Insular Investigation Bureau at 772-2171, Police Emergency 911, or you can call Crime Stoppers USVI at 1-800-222-TIPS. Police said Lickout also has active warrants for various charges, including fraud and larceny, in Florida and Washington State.
And of course, it is Wednesday, time for your Crime Stoppers report. And sitting in for Judy Fricks is our own Wes Small.
Thanks a lot, Jerome. It is Wednesday, and here's your Crime Stoppers report. It's pretty simple. If you know something, say something. Police need your eyes and ears. The smallest bit of information could be just enough to close a case. Starting on St. Croix, Saturday, January 22nd, around 5:30 in the morning, 29-year-old Amaya Leftui was shot and killed as he was driving east on Queen Mary Highway near Castle Burke. That's when a car pulled up next to him and then opened fire. He was then killed, helped solve the senseless killing. The minimum cash reward for that homicide is $1,500, $1,500. Taken at the St. John on Tuesday, January 11th at 2 p.m., police were called to the Merchants Commercial Bank on St. John in response to a robbery. There we have two armed men stormed into the bank and robbed it of an undisclosed sum of money. Then they escaped in a blue Suzuki Jimny. And both of those suspects were masked. One was wearing a blue jumpsuit and white sneakers. The minimum reward for that arrest of a bank robber is $900, plus 10% of any cash that is recovered. The minimum cash reward is $2,500. That's $2,500. And then finally on St. Thomas, Thursday, January 27th at 7:45 in the morning on 2nd Street, a woman who just dropped off her child at daycare was robbed of her gold chain as she was getting back into her car. The suspect, who ran eastward towards Oswald Harris Court, is described as a Hispanic light-skinned male. And he is 18 to 25 years of age at about 5'8" tall. The minimum cash reward for that robber is $900. We believe that your tips help police make 5 additional arrests in this month alone. Please keep it up. Just call 1-800-222-TIPS, 1-800-8477. Be safe out there. I'm Wes Small at Ann Schrader Command for News Channel 8.
Also tonight, police have arrested a man for stealing his sister's registered police weapon. Here's Melody Rames again with more on that.
Criminal Investigation Bureau detectives on St. Croix arrested 23-year-old Jaheim Benjamin based on an arrest warrant charging him with grand larceny. Police said that on December 29, 2010, Benjamin stole the service revolver belonging to his sister, who is a law enforcement officer. Police said Benjamin, who lives in the same residence as his sister, stole the weapon while she was taking a shower. Several days later, the weapon was turned over to another family member, who in turn turned it over to police. Benjamin, who is a resident of Estate Upper Love, was arrested at about 9 a.m. on Wednesday, February 2nd, based on a Superior Court arrest warrant dated January 28th. He was held on a $75,000 bail and remanded to the custody of Golden Grove Adult Correctional Facility, pending further court action.
Thanks, Melody Rames of the Virgin Islands Police Department. And your Caribbean report is coming up next. Stay with us.